Hi, greetings and welcome, fellow sci-fi comic fans. We are here today at the Comicon Festival here in London at the MCM. My missus here, saying hi. Hi.
Watch out, hiya.
As previously we've had previous problems with the sound on these, so I'm trying to attempt to use my phone as a sound recording device, and I'm going to try and overlay the sound to the video later as we go along. Hopefully it will work. Now also I've noticed that the lens seems to be fuzzing up. It seems to be clouding over a little bit, but hopefully it won't happen too much during the course of the day. You may notice different types of shots. That's where I've taken the lenses off and just gone basically bareback with the camera. Hopefully we'll see if we can get some decent footage. We have arrived here a little bit late considering how much traffic that we've had. The trains were out, so we had to take the buses here. We've finally now got here. Let's see what's going around.
I think so.
Is there anything in particular you want to look for?
I'm going to have a little bit of an explore around to see what's there.
Okay. What about your costume? What have you come as? Can you guess it, ladies and gentlemen?
Well, I've come as Newt Scalamander. My wand and my Niffler, if he's still in there, is in my bag, nice and safe and sound. He'll come out later.
Yeah, just don't steal too much jewellery along the way.
Hell no. Okay. So, we got our green passes?
Yep, green tags.
Synchronising green passes? Let's go!
See you later.
Good to see you again.
We met at the last
McM
Comicon. He told us about the wonderful game of White Day, his company was bringing out. And how did White Day go?
White Day's done well, yeah. It came out in August to a very good reception.
Yeah.
It's obviously Halloween now as we're recording this, so yeah. Like, it's ramping up again. We've got a bit of a Halloween sale going on. We've got some new DLC coming out as well with some cool costumes. Right. So, we're still all about the White Day.
Okay, cool. So, in between then and now, your company's come out with quite a few different games since then.
Yeah, we've got a lot of games coming out. So, we're going to give you a quick tour of some of the other games that we've got coming. First one will be Cat Quest, which comes out in November.
Okay, big Cat Quest, yeah.
So, this is like an isometric RPG, action RPG, from a developer called The Gentle Bros, who are based in Singapore. It's already out on Steam, but it's coming to PlayStation 4 and Nintendo Switch. It's P-Cube's first Nintendo Switch game, so we're very happy about that.
Okay.
And that's cool. In November.
Okay. Can we just see what's going on here at the moment?
Yeah, sure. So you play as a cat, obviously. It's called Cat Quest. And you are the Dragon Blood. So,
Dragon
Blood. Obviously, if like there are any Skyrim fans out there, they may get a sense of what's going on. You are able to slay dragons. So you're shipwrecked near this island in Feeling Guard, which is the universe of Cat Quest.
Feeling Guard, yeah.
And Feeling Guard, yeah. There's loads of puns. If you like puns, it's full of puns. And your sister is kidnapped by an evil guy called Drakoff. And so you want to rescue your sister. But when you land on the island, there are loads of dragons that you have to fight. You're going through dungeons to clear them out of enemies. Tons of loot, many, many, many puns, lots of jokes. It's a lot of fun.
Sounds perfect.
Excellent.
Okay. What else have we got going on?
What's the best way around? Should we go this way?
We'll go around. Yep.
Probably our most popular title here today.
Let's move this here so we can see what's going on here. Yep.
So So our most popular title here at Comic Con is Under Night in Birth EXE Latest, which is a mouthful, I know.
So sorry, what was that again?
don't make me say it. Under Night in Birth EXE Latest, or Uniest.
Uniest.
For short, Uniest. Which is the latest Arc System work. Well, it's an Arc System Works slash French bred fighter. So Arc System Works make Dragon Ball Fighters in Guilty Gear and Blaze Blue. They're publishing this in Japan. It's actually a developer called French Bread that made Melty Blood on PlayStation 2. So if you've got any hardcore fighting fans, you know they're PS2 fighters.
Yeah.
Melty Blood is a bit of a classic.
Okay.
So this is their brand new game. Well, there is a version on PS3. This is the most up-to-date version with extra characters, a 10-hour story mode.
Fatalities?
No fatalities. We'll leave that to Mortal Kombat and the guys at NetherRealm to do. We respect those guys a lot. But really fun fighter. A bit more ground-based than some of the Arc System games. So Blaze Blue, Guilty Gear, quite fast-paced. Lots of juggles. This is more ground-based. A little bit more like a Street Fighter game to play. Obviously, though, huge anime stylings. A great, great fighter. So that's coming out soon. I can't say when, but it's coming soon to PlayStation 4.
Okay, cool. Cool. Okay.
And then, if we go around here... I need to reset this one, actually. This is the worst time to come in.
So pause the game. Pause the game.
Pause.
Pause it. Yeah, we'll pause it. I'll pause it on that. Okay, sorry.
Cool. So we actually have two unannounced titles here. We've got three, but only two on display currently. So this one here is called Nippon Marathon.
Ippon. That was the name of the game that I was trying to think of, the Japanese devil.
So this is a four-player party racing game. We're actually on the intro screen here, so if the guys press A, they can actually get into the game. So a physics-based four-player racing game where you pick up fruits, you eat it to move faster, you throw it at people to slow them down and knock them over. You're chased by dogs, you get knocked over by bicycles. If I jump on, actually, I can give you an example. So I'll just do a one-player mode. Barrels come rolling down the street, you're running on top of wooden planks over raging rivers. We've got one level here on display at Comic-Con. There will be 10 levels in the final game. And basically, it's a grand marathon across the whole of Japan, where lots of crazy stuff happens. But sometimes you might have to get involved in slot machine mini games. Sometimes you might get involved in a live TV interview with a Japanese newscaster. One of the playable characters is the dog, which is actually the dog of the developer. He's got a Jack Russell called Buster, who is in the game, which is amazing. And this is the most gloriously fun party game you could ever imagine. So this is a scoop. We've not announced this yet, so you are the first person with this.
Hey.
This is coming to early access early in 2018. There will be more formal announcements in a few weeks' time, where we'll be announcing all the formats and release plans. But this is probably my personal favourite of the show, if I'm being truly honest with you. It's just crazy fun. In the office, we have been guffawing like crazy over this one. There's nothing quite like it. I'm glad I won, actually. That's good to win on screen. Phew, it goes so wrong so quickly. It's very easy to get knocked out. So here we go. So this is a great example of one of the zany interludes. It's the Katai News Network. Weddy is going to come down on a jetpack, as she does, to interview everyone.
As you do, of course.
Yeah, of course. And she's probably going to ask us maybe about pandas. I don't know what we've got here. It's always random. Oh, no. She wants to know how our average morning is. So you then have a multiple choice system where you have to select your answer, but only one person can answer. Only one person can say any particular phrase. So you can block off other people from picking certain phrases. And then you form a sentence, and then at the end of the day, at the end of the interview, the fans vote for what was a popular answer and what wasn't. Sadly, I gave a very terrible answer. See, that's a good sentence. He's probably going to do quite well from that.
So definitely, is this a? It looked like a very much a party style game.
Definitely,
is
yeah.
Is it going to be available across the internet, or is it all going to be just on home console?
So we will be making official announcements about that in the coming weeks. Let's say. Local multiplayer is where the heart of this game lies, because when you can all sit on a couch and play together, that's great fun. But we also fully appreciate that some people might want to play with people remotely. So we're still in development. As I say, it's not even hit early access yet. Time will tell on that front, but we're well aware of what people will want from this.
Cool.
So that's Nippon Marathon. I say my personal favourite of the show. Close behind it is this game next to it, which is a four-player racing game. It's called Street Heat.
Street Heat.
So it's a neon noir local and online racer.
Yeah.
With a vibrant 80s soundtrack. The soundtrack is phenomenal. If you like Micro Machines, if you like Mashed, if you like the PS1 Circuit Breakers.
Childhood memory.
Exactly.
Right there.
this is absolutely the game for you. So. All the tracks all on one screen, so the camera doesn't move around. You see where everyone is at any given time, and there's some obstacles, so they're like oil slicks that can send you spiraling off the track. There's a train that comes racing through, crossing over the track, which will crash you out of the race. And currently in this version there are no respawns. So this will be hitting early access in late November, and it's brutal, because if you take someone out, they're out of that race until the next round. But it's quick fire, so you have multiple rounds per race, effectively.
So you can basically spend the game, spend the race eliminating the opponent.
Exactly. So let me demo. I'll see what pad we've got set up here.
Just checking to make sure that the video is still recording.
There is a chance I've got the wrong pad, so yes, let me pick up the other. So I need to catch up.
Have the right
so I hate this track just because it's a blind turn there, and so I always go careening off the edge. But a fantastic little arcade racer. You want to really drift around every track. Points are awarded based on your finishing placement, but also on whoever gets the fastest lap, and also if you eliminate people. So even if, like that, I've crashed out, so I'm out of the race now, but if I got the fastest lap, then I'd get a point still. So that's a great, great race that we've got coming out end of November.
Okay.
Cool. And then we've got... that's it for our games that are coming out, and we've got a few that have just been released. So I'll show you one more around the corner.
With you. Okay. Cool.
This is our newest release. This is called Rabby Ribby.
Rabby Ribby,
which is on PlayStation 4 and PS Vita. And it's a Metroidvania-style 2D action platformer.
Nice.
So you play as a rabbit who has been transformed into a human, and she doesn't know why. So she's trying to find her owner. And it turns out like there are a lot of people who dress up as rabbits who are... they're not technically furries, but they're not the friendliest of people. So lots of boss battling. You can see here one of the boss battles. Take the form of bullet hell shooters. So 2D platformer Metroidvania that becomes a bullet hell shooter in the boss battles.
We're looking like running and gunning.
Yeah, so you get loads of different power-ups, new weapons. A nice mishmash of different playstyles. I think it was Outland, I can't remember, Outland or Outlast, the Ubisoft 2D Metroidvania that was spliced with Ikaruga back on last generation. I guess that's the closest comparison in something doing the two styles. But this is tons of fun. There's over 40 bosses, so loads of that bullet hell action gameplay going on, which I absolutely love. We have many, many more games, but it'll take me all day to talk you through them all.
It looks like we've certainly got a lot of great games that are coming out. Everything from 2D beat 'em up to racing, and even Bullet Storm.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, Anything else you'd like to say before we finish up, we wrap up?
All I'll say is we've got a lot more to announce. We've given you a sneak peek of two unannounced games. We've got another few announcements in the next few months. One game that we don't have here at the show is Galgun 2, which is going to be massive. Galgun Double Piece is one of our most infamous games. Galgun 2 is coming to PlayStation 4 and Nintendo Switch.
I was going to say, to be perfectly honest, considering how family-friendly our platform is, I'm not too sure that would have been Galgun would have been appropriate for, considering, yes.
Yeah, so that, but many, many others. So just stay tuned to the airwaves, the internet waves, because P-Cube has a lot more to say very soon.
Okay, cool. And finally, do you have a web page or a web address?
Yeah, so we're at www.pcube.co.uk /games.
pqube.co.uk. Okay, cool. Got there in the end. Okay, well, thanks very much. Been a pleasure.
Thanks very much.
Hooray!